So hello everyone, welcome to Brainwaves Chess Club. Today we are going to see a short and sweet game played between Dubov Daniel and Temur Rajchapov. So let me tell you that Dubov Daniel is a Russian chess grandmaster and he achieved his final chess grandmaster nom at the age of 14, and his opponent is Temur Rajchapov, who is an Azerbaijani chess player and is currently ranked as world number 9. So this game was played in 2019, in which Dubov Daniel had the white pieces and Temur Rajchapov had the black pieces. So without further ado, let's check it out. But before starting the game, do subscribe to our channel and also hit the bell icon and turn on the notifications to all to be updated for our future videos. So let's get started. So I started the game via the move e4, e5 by black, knight to f3, knight to c6, bishop to c4, bishop to c5, white castles, knight to f6 by black, and here a shocking move d4. And this is known as the Italian Kotlovansky Gambit. So three options exist for black: knight into d4, bishop into d4, or pawn into d4. So bishop into d4 was played in the game, which is actually the best move in this position. But let's see what happens if black captures the pawn with the knight. So after knight into d4, here comes knight into e5. And now you can see that the f7 pawn is attacked twice, so black has to castle here. But now comes bishop to e3. And now you can see that the d4 knight is attacked twice, and now the knight has to go to e6 to guard the c5 bishop. But now comes bishop into e6, and now you cannot recapture the e6 bishop because the bishop on c5 is hanging. So black has to play here bishop into e3, but now comes bishop to f7 check. And now doesn't matter black captures the bishop or not, black is going to be an exchange down. So let's see if black captures the bishop with the move rook to f7. But now comes knight into f7. So after king into f7, here comes the move pawn into e3. And now you can see that white is a clear exchange up. And let's see if black doesn't capture the bishop and plays king to h8. But now comes bishop to b3. And now you can see that there are two threats, knight to f7 and f into e3. And black cannot defend these both threats at the same time. So black is going to be an exchange down. And let's see if black plays pawn into d4. Here comes the move e5, and this is known as the max line attack, but I am not going to cover it in deep because the video would be too long then. So you can check out for max line attack videos on YouTube, and if you want me to make a video on max line attack, please let me know in the comment section. So bishop to d4 was played in the game. Here comes knight into d4, knight into d4 by black, bishop to g5, d6, f4, and here comes the move bishop to g5. And now you have to be very careful because you cannot move your queen to anywhere because all that moves are just losing. Let's see each by turn. Let's see if you place your queen to d2, here comes knight into e4. So queen to d2 is not possible. And let's see if you move your queen to c1, here comes bishop to e2. And now you cannot move your rook because the bishop will be hanging. And if you play bishop into bishop, here comes simply knight into e2, and you are losing your queen. So queen to c1 is also not possible. And let's see if you move your queen to d3, but still comes bishop to e2, and you are losing an exchange. And the last try, let's see if you place your queen to e1, here comes simply knight into c2. So moving the queen is not possible in this position, and considering all that threats, white played here bishop to f6, bishop to d1 by black, bishop to d8, rook to d8, and here white could have simply captured the d1 bishop, and after knight to c2, knight to c3, knight to a1, and after rook into a1, this position is completely drawn and equal. But white decided to play the move c3. And now black cannot move the knight because the bishop on d1 would be hanging and black will be a piece down. So black played here bishop to e2, and now white cannot capture the bishop because after knight to e2 and king to f2, white loses a pawn. So after bishop to e2, white played here pawn into d4, and after bishop into d4, rook to c1, black played here bishop to d3. But now comes the move rook to c7. So black played here rook to d7, rook to c8 check, rook to d8, and now white decided to exchange one pair of rooks. So rook to d8 by black, king into d8, and now white played pawn into e5, but now comes the move bishop into b1, and after rook into b1, both the players agreed to a draw because this position is completely equal and there is no more chance to play for a win from both the sides. So let's see if black plays here d into e5, and after f5, both the players have equal pawns and the position is also totally equal. So that's why after rook into b1, both the players agreed to a draw. So I hope you enjoyed the video and make sure to hit the like button. We will be coming up with more amazing and interesting videos like this.